Want to know the five most obvious things you should do before listing your house for sale? Listen up. What's up, guys? Steve Bazzagna here from Keller Williams, Philly's real estate agent. Today, we're going to be talking about the five things that you could do that are the most easy and obvious things you could do to make your house more saleable here in the Philadelphia area. One, find a good real estate agent. Do not go into this as a for sale by owner. You are going to get your butt whooped by a certified negotiation expert on the other end. They're going to come in here. They're going to make you feel like you won the negotiation when in fact you really didn't. It's better to have a real estate agent there for you. Plus, it takes up way too much time. Hire a real estate agent, have them take all the calls, have them show the house, have them walk people through it, have them put the professional marketing behind it, have them deal with all the legal paperwork involved. I mean, just so you know, an offer is 14 pages of legal crap that you know, I'm sure you probably don't want to have to go through. Hire a real estate agent. Plus, homes sold with a real estate agent, according to NAR, NAR is the National Association of Real Estate Agents or Realtors. The National Association of Realtors said that homes sold through a realtor sold for 20% sold 20% faster than homes that didn't. So if you're looking for speed, don't do it yourself. If you're looking, they also sold for more money. So if you want more money too, don't do it yourself. Also, rule number two, declutter using the rule of threes. Rule of threes is on every horizontal or vertical surface, don't have more than three things. So it actually gets rid of clutter. It makes the home look more open and spacious. And it saves you a lot of money. So that's use that as well. Number three, remove pet smell. Believe it or not, smell is extremely important. Like probably the most important aspect of the home. Because I know when I open a door, when I show my buyers a home, if I walk in that door and it smells bad, I can guarantee you that the buyer's not going to buy that house. If it walks in, I smell mildew or pets or cat pee or something like that. Like, I just know the buyer, you know, almost instantly the showing is almost over because the smell is so bad. Smell is extremely important. The house has to smell good. I can't emphasize that enough. Also, fix the small things, loose doors, wall marks, any kind of loose thing that you can think of, loose toilets, shaky appliances, doors, wherever it is, whatever kind of small things you've got going on in the house that are, you know, maybe the little trinkets in the house that you think, you know, that only you would know about, fix those little things, because what's going to happen is they're going to come back to bite you later. Do not cut corners, fix the small stuff. And then also be realistic on the price. Look, I know I have never met a seller who doesn't want more than their house is actually worth. Every seller wants more than the house is actually worth, but it's really, really important to be realistic. And I tell the sellers I work with is if you have a price up here and then, you know, market values here and then buyers are all down here, you want to bring that, picture your price as a magnet and you want to bring it as close to market value as possible so it has more pull on all the buyers. And if you move your magnet away from market value, you're not going to have a whole lot of pull on all the buyers down here. So just wanted to kind of make you guys aware of all those things. Hopefully you guys got a lot of value out of that, and I will see you guys in the next video.